Hello everybody. Let's start for the day today. So today I'll be covering most of the aspects of the payroll aspects, starting with Element. Yesterday we submitted but we couldn't do anything out there. So today I'll be taking you through the elements. So first, as I discussed yesterday, I will start with the elements. Okay. So I'm already in my project that I created yesterday, the implementation project, MIRA-IR implementation project. Okay. Under workforce deployment, under defined payroll, you have something called as defined earnings and deductions. So that is where you'll find your manage element. In case you are unable to do this here, you can always search from the task list here. There's always, you can always select. In case you just put it as elements, and you will still be able to, the system will guide you through as to what is the selected scope there, and once you put it, so once you search, so you should still be able to go to the elements. So this will ensure that you get the elements list. So in case you are not aware of any of the drop down where to go and that way, so even if you have to create departments, etc., you can search it in the search window, and you will be able to, the system will guide you where you have to exactly navigate through. This is, say, workforce deployment, defined common application configuration, human capital management. So it will guide you across. So when you click this, it will automatically take you to the page where managed departments can be defined. You can go to the task. I'll get back to the elements here. So let's create elements. So here, selecting the scope, what exactly the system tells us is, it tells us, please define your legislative data group. So what, as I said yesterday, legislative data group is nothing but where you define which legal entity it has to be associated with, what are the legal aspects for that particular payroll, and which jurisdiction is it covering. So all that will ensure that the legislative data group assigned to the payroll or to the elements will cascade the information across to these elements, etc. So I will say we are selecting the scope. So what happens is, in case, since this is a training environment, I would have selected a scope. So in case you are doing it parallelly, then you will have to select a different scope altogether, because if you are using the same project. So I would suggest that in case you are using, please create your own implementation projects and use, so that it is easier for you in terms of scope selection. I will just add yesterday I created a MIUS LDG, so I will select and add that. Okay, I'm searching for that. Okay, this is the LDG that I have created. Okay, so now whatever I create, okay, any element that I create will be under this LDG. That is the reason you don't see the element here. I will open a parallel instance, so that you will know exactly how this works. So let me go to setup and maintenance and search for the task manage elements, so that you will know exactly the difference in the screen. Okay, see here you see the legislative data group, but here you don't see the legislative data group, although this is the same same screens that we are seeing. Why we are not seeing the legislative data group out here is because we have already set the scope and then come into this. So whenever I create a element here, so the legislative data group will be automatically taken. But the same thing when I create a element here, it will ask me for a legislative data group. Is that okay?
So basically, if you select via scope, by default,
yes,
selecting MIUS data legislative.
Correct. Well, in case you have a single LDG, then you don't have to worry, because you can set the scope and come in and start working. But when you have multiple LDGs, we will not set the scope. So we will search the elements and then give our own, meaning if you have to create for all of the LDGs the elements, then we will use this part. So we will not select the scope there. Or you can do that, change the scope and come back again. That is also a possibility. Meaning every time you create all the elements for one legal entity, change the scope of the LDG to another, then create all the elements and then take it up. I will create a basic salary. Okay, I will backdate it to
When you
1990.
say basic salary, means that the regular wages?
Yes. This is like, say for example, I'm viewing a pay slip, okay? So assuming this is my paycheck that I'm having, so it will have basic salary. I will have a housing allowance. Then I will have a transportation allowance. Maybe I have a car allowance. Okay, so on and so forth. So I will have an amount here. So this is typically how my paycheck is going to look with all the deductions and additions, etc., etc. So similarly, I will create. Yeah, sorry.
What about the PTO hours? Will it be defaulted?
Sorry, I didn't get you that.
For the PTO hours.
Yeah, you have to see, for everything, there's nothing to be defaulted. Everything in payroll has to be created.
So even for including PTO also, we need to manage.
Yes. Yeah, I will show you how that works. I will let you know how the PTO element is also created. I'm giving a recurring element. Okay, I'm just taking the seeded ones. Okay, flat amount. Default periodicity is calendar month. Okay, I'm saying standard rate. Okay, so I've kept it at specific. I've taken the vanilla values. Okay, I will submit this. So what happens exactly is, once the element is submitted, we have something called, once we have an element creation screen. So what do we tell the system? Okay, this is my element. You pay so much for the employee, and this is the tax that will be deducted for this employee. So all these elements will be created, meaning including your deductions as well as your standard earnings, whether be it voluntary deductions, involuntary deductions. Voluntary deductions, you have taken up something on a social charity, etc. That also, if you want the company to deduct it, you can do that. In case there is involuntary deductions, like tax deductions, there are certain amounts. If you have taken a loan in the company, so that will be get deducting. That will get deducted. So all these are involuntary deductions. So what happens exactly is that all this will form elements. So all that you see in your paycheck, line by line components that you see, will be part of an element.
My question is this. I've been involved in a project that we have, over 30 different elements that is created for different categories of employees. Now, because I'm looking at this creation of elements, if I have like that 30 elements to be created, so I have to follow, this same process. And looking at
yes.
the time, it's taking to
pick elements. Not really. It will not take so much time in your regular instances, pods. So that will be faster. Here it is a training environment, so this will take a little time. So otherwise, it will not take, it will take mere about 5 minutes for you to create the element with respect to all the values that you have. Meaning from page starting one, meaning there is train stops, right? One, two, three pages. So it should not take such long time. So it's already submitted. In the training environment, it will not take beyond 2-3 minutes. So in the regular environment where you have no elements created, it will be much faster. Because we have said that this is belonging to a US LDG. So you see that I have not given any input values, but there are something called a state. I will show you this. Let us click on input salaries. I will. You have something called as state, you have something called as county, you can input values, but normally amount is the value that we normally input for the employees. That is the value that will go into the, so this will be the, this is called primary input value. So if you see the state, so this, there is no special purpose here. Okay, if you see the pay value, There's no special purpose here. So when it comes to amount, that is what we enter for the employees. Okay. Yesterday, while we were creating a salary base, there was an element and an input value. So this is the value you are going to enter for the element.
My other question is this. Now, when we created this element, we pick flat amount. In the course of the training, I also want us to pick a particular element without picking a flat amount, and maybe that element will now be a kind of either percentage or formula around a particular element, so that we use flat amount for the other. Let's say, for instance, if we have a transport allowance now, and maybe transport allowance is maybe 10% of the value of a basic. I would like to know how does that relate together and how that done.
I have clicked on something called as auto indirect rules. So what happens is, in case your element is getting from a different element altogether, okay, and I have like, say for example, 10% of a basic salary or 10% of some other value, okay. So I will create another element for that and put that element here. Say let me put this for an example. Okay, I will write a formula for the element to be picked up from that particular element and add the value into this pay value here. Yes, is that what was your ask?
Yes, so I really want to see how that works, so that we really see, like, because those are the things that we see in the live risk scenario.
At present, I will not be able to reproduce that. In the coming classes, we will try and do that. Let me complete the initial stages of the training, and then we can see that. I will tell you how that is added, and you will have the access to the instance as well. So you will be able to create that yourself. I will be taking you through how you create multiple elements and attach it to the salary basis. To the employee. Okay, so this element you can use. There are a lot of formulas that you can attach here. There's fast formulas that you see here, and this is input values which are seeded, meaning which is Oracle given here. And whenever you create an element, there's something called as an element eligibility, meaning what we tell the system is, you're not only creating an element, so I should tell the system as to what payroll or which location the element is getting attached to, what is that I want to confine that element to. Say, when I create an element eligibility, I can tell the system that you process this element only for this department or this legal employer, the position. So I create, say, normally it is a norm that we create the element eligibility with the same name as the element. Okay, so you can ensure that your element gets processed only for this particular payroll. If you have already created a payroll, we haven't created a payroll, so you don't see a list of value here. Otherwise, you will see the list of values here. So in case you have created for this particular job and only element has to be available for that particular, like, say for example, in the media industry, what happens is there are people who are into different line of work. So each might get a different bonus levels, or a person in the the studio and a person in a different department might get different elements. So you can define that here itself, meaning you can confine your elements to a particular payroll or a particular department, even for grades. Like a VP might get a particular level of bonus. So I can tell that when the grade is VP, please attach this element to the employee. What exactly is that automatic entry? There's a field called automatic entry. So when I click this, when it is a basic salary, in case you want that element to be attached whenever you create an employee, it is like auto provisioning of roles. Like in auto provisioning of roles, what happens? I create an employee, I tell the system that employee role should be attached automatically. Similarly here as well, I can tell the system that this element has to be attached to the employees whenever there is an employee that is created. That is what automatic entry means here. So your calculation formulas, in case you have a lot of calculations in validations, like I want a validation to be entered for this employee, for this element, then I use a validation formula. In case there is a defaulting, then I define all these formulas. I'll show you how, where the formula is also defined in the later classes. So as of now, you can confine your basic elements, your elements to legal employer, department, job, grade. Even you can say that employment category, I want only this element to be available for the full-time people, or only part-timers will get this element. So at that time, you can select this value and say only full-time regular will get this. In case you are creating, I don't want any conditions, then I will go and save. I'll show you what input values are here. And this date is very important. So before that, if you create an employee, the element will not be available. Meaning if you are creating an employee as of 89, this element will not be available for you. See, this is the state. This is what you see here, state, country, city, etc. So these are the same values that you can see here. Okay. And every element, meaning when I'm paid salary, what happens from the financial end is that I'm costed. There's general ledger and I have a costing principle associated. Meaning for every element, be it basic or let me say every employee has a cost associated with himself or herself. So anything that is paid to the employee or deducted to the employee has to come into the general ledger. So this element, when I create, be it a deduction element or be it a earnings element, so, or a taxation element as well, so I ensure that there's a costing. So this, I give it a costing information, like whether it has to go to general ledger, etc. So this will come into picture on when there is finance module. Otherwise, in case you want it to be costed and still take out information, you can still do that. But you need to do the required setups for that. So normally this costing comes up when there is finance module. Once you have determined your eligibility, that is for the element, okay, I can tell the system, I can go and check for a employee. So before that, now I have told that there's an element. Okay, so I have defined my element, I have defined an element eligibility. Okay, when I look at a payroll, okay, so what happens is it starts, how do I get paid? The company doesn't come and give it to me at the desk. So I get either paid through checks or through cash or through direct transfers these days. So when it comes to banks, meaning there is a wire transfer that is happening, so we need to do certain setups as well. So that setup is what you see here, the banking setups. Once I create elements, what happens is I create a payroll relationship. I attach these elements to a particular elements attach it to a particular eligibility. In case what we did is an open eligibility, meaning I have not set any conditions here. So this is an open eligibility. In case you set certain eligibilities, you can try out that while you are doing your practices. You just have to create and ensure that you put a employment category and when you are, or a department. So when you put a department, it will appear only for that particular department. And if you have an employee in a different department, then the element will not be appearing. And the same with the legal employer. Like yesterday I was telling, we can secure the view from the others. Like if an employee, if a user is in Spain and the user, another user is in US and both of them should not see each other's data, then what happens is here I will block it by the legal employer. So I will select my basic salary element to be available only to the legal employer of US, and I will create another basic salary element which will be associated with the legal employer of Spain. Also, we should remember that Spain and US are of different legal entity because they are based out of two different jurisdictions. So your LDG will be different. So that way, most of the and when you set the scope, you will be setting the scope for a particular LDG. and hence your data will be confined to that particular legal entity or legal employer.